out all four semi-finalists were, of course, from China, which means that we have an all-Chinese women's singles final. Wang Xin, the number three seed, up against the number two seed, Wang Yihan. Now, neither of these players have actually won the China Open before, so we will get a new name on the trophy. Good to see Bulgarian Nedelcheva coming through to quarter-final stage, and in fact, in the first round, she put out the three-time defending champion, Jiang Yangjiao. Old left hand up, Wang Xin. She's won the last three Super Series events in Denmark, France, and last week in Hong Kong. Can she make it four in a row? Well, she's up against the new world number one, because Wang Yihan regained her number one spot in the world on the world ranking that was published earlier this week. She is, of course, the reigning world champion, Wang Yihan, having won the title in Wembley earlier this year, beating Chen Xiaoxie of Taipei in that final. No, one or two upsets this week in the women's singles. Number one seed, Wang Shuxian, losing out in the second round to the world junior champion, Intanon Arachanok of Thailand. As I was saying, Petia Nedelcheva. Superb win for her in the her opening match, disposing of the three-time defending champion, Jiang Yangjiao. But for these two players, both of them outstanding this year, both of them having won five titles. Wang Xin on a great run, appearing in her fourth consecutive final of four tournaments played. Simon Oh of Hong Kong is our umpire. He really came on to the world tour in 2009, left-handed Wang Xin. Wang Yihan has been a regular for a number of years now. This, in fact, her seventh appearance here at the China Open, even though she's only 23 years of age. But I guess the crowd is going to be behind Wang Yihan because she is from Shanghai. Tall, elegant athlete is Wang Yihan. 178, that's about 5'10". World ranking up one place from last week to number one in the world. Regained that status that she held for almost a year between October 2009 and September 2010. Well, she's had two very tough matches in the last two rounds. First of all, against Nedelcheva, three games there, and then yes, yesterday evening against Liu Xin. So to the world number three. And number three seed. She too had a very tough match yesterday evening. Needed three games to beat her teammate Li Shorei. But hasn't played against a seeded player. Neither of them have. And Ian, that's quite extraordinary.
Yes, certainly at the beginning of the week the conditions were very slow. And in those slow conditions you would expect to get one or two upsets, and that's certainly been the case this week.
Well, we saw the head-to-head record, and this is the eighth meeting between these two players. Fifth meeting this year. 5-2 on the previous seven, the advantage to Wang Yihan. But it was the left-hander Wang Xin who's won on the last two occasions, the semi-final last week in Hong Kong, and also the final of the Denmark Open. Only once has it been the full distance. I have to go back 2 years for that, for the semi-final of the Hong Kong Open in 2009. And that, to me, is surprising. So the women's singles final. Wang Xin, far side of the court, was beaten finalist here 2 years ago. Losing out to Jiang Yanxiao. This lady making her first appearance here on finals day of the China Open. Twice a semi-finalist previously. Now, Ian, there's interesting statistics here as far as rankings are concerned, because Wang Yihan up one place in the world rankings, but down one place to number two on the Super Series rankings. And that is because Wang Xin has gone up two places on the Super Series rankings to number one. So these two players will contest the Super Series finals to be staged in Luzhou from the 14th to the 18th of December. And that means that until last week, the number one player in the world, Wang Shuxian, doesn't qualify for the Super Series finals.
Yeah, it's been a tight battle between the three of them all year, really. Between the three of them, they've fairly dominated the Super Series this year. And as you say, it's a strange thing that the player that's been world number one for much of that period won't actually be qualifying for the finals now.
Yeah, we ought to just explain that only two per country are permitted at the Super Series finals. Top eight in each discipline, providing there's not more than two per nation.
We've already seen one or two classic Wang Xin rallies, where she's changing the direction the whole time, trying to keep Wang Yihan off balance.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a well-constructed rally. Forcing Wang Yihan three times into that deep round-the-head corner. And then switching the direction, using the diagonal, see how she keeps her opponent off balance. Good precision to win the point. We saw that quite a lot in the final in Denmark, Jill, where Wang Xin tried to build a lot from that deep backhand corner of Wang Yihan. There she goes again.
Oh, nicely done.
Because when she goes to that other corner, Wang Yihan's very, very accurate from the deep forehand corner.
Thank you. and wide.
Grueling rally. Both players playing really well in that rally, both having opportunities. In the end, that's a good angle from Wang Yihan. Forcing her opponent to take it so late that it gives her time to get into that net position to play the winning shot.
And of course, in both these players, it's such grueling matches. Late yesterday evening, Wang Xin, well, she had to overcome Li Shurei, lost the opening game, 55 minutes before she came through 23-21 in the decider, whereas this lady, Wang Yihan, needed an hour and 13 minutes for her victory over Liu Xin. Dropped the second game, so both of them very, very physical matches last night.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how they react in this game, whether there is any tiredness after those matches.
Not only physical tiredness, but I wonder about emotionally drained as well, perhaps. You know, especially this lady, Wang Xin, so close. In fact, her opponent was 1 point away from winning the match.
She'd be disappointed there. She read the cross drop from Wang Yihan. She knows that's Wang Yihan's favourite from that corner. Read it well and then missed the block.
Just wide.
That was close. And again, it's that tactic of pushing deep to the backhand corner and then switching the attack. There we go. Making her opponent late in that corner, then trying to use the diagonal.
Clever. Saw that Wang Xin was backing off from the net. Swayed her body one way. This is the one coming up. And then hits it the other, block back to the net. Very clever indeed.
Yeah, that's too flat for Wang Yihan and she knows it. She likes to use that cross lift from the forehand, but that was just too flat. Gave her opponent the chance to intercept the shuttle early. Nice play. Again, just holding Wang Yihan. Flicking into the rear court. There it is, little hold. Forcing her opponent off balance. Creates the opportunity.
A 5 point advantage at the mid-game interval. Surprisingly quick, just 7 minutes.
Well, that could be explained by your previous point, Jill. The fact, I think, certainly Wang Xin's showing one or two signs of being a little bit weary. A couple of times when she's lunged at the net, she's been a little bit off balance. And I think both players are being quite aggressive in their shot selection, not wanting to play the longer rallies, which you would normally certainly expect from Wang Xin. She's being more aggressive than we would normally expect to see.
She's got quite heavy strapping on her right knee, but I wonder, picking up on your point, Ian, whether the accumulation of tightness, I mean, her fourth consecutive final in four tournaments played. That is fantastic.
Yeah, it's a good point, Jill. She's been on a very good run, been exceptional form. But it will catch up with her at some stage.
And she has been exceptionally good this year in finals, because reached five finals, won five finals. Wang Yihan reached seven finals, but only winning five. Only winning five.
That's another example. Wang's in there, no patience, went for the cross drive when she was late rather than clearing out and starting the rally again. And then couldn't cover the diagonal herself. Real signs that she's a little bit tired here. Again, pressure into that deep backhand corner. And that creates the space in the front court. That's a more patient rally from Wang Xin. It's more the type of rally expected to see. Reactions. Yihan looking to catch Wang Xin off guard and pushing at the body, but Wang Xin showing very good racket skills there, quickly into position.
So well, making her move the full diagonal of the court time and time again.
Yeah, again, made a late in the rear court, and that creates the space.
Oof. Error on the return of serve. Straight points. But the run comes to an end, but she's got herself back into this opening game. Now it's believable. And she was 7 points adrift. Felt there was a real danger of Wang Yihan just running away with the opening game. Oh, that's nice. Very nice.
Yeah, just anticipated that return, didn't she? She knows Wang Xin's been looking to try and exploit that deep corner. This time she got up early. Managed to intercept the shuttle early, bring it down very steeply.
Following forward. Well, she touched it, surely.
Well, that's a strange one. Difficult to tell from there, but the linesman certainly felt she'd touched it because he didn't want to call, did he?
Oh, that is just fabulous.
There's the difference. When you go to that forehand corner, she's so dangerous.
Oh, here we go. Problem with the knee. And the umpire is calling for the tournament referee, who in turn will call for the doctor. And I suspect that Wang Sin has had enough. Here comes the tournament referee, Isabelle Jobard from France. And the medical team are being called. You think she's had enough, Ian?
Yeah, I think she's gone out there and she's given it a real go, but that is heavy strapping and it was a very, very hard match last night.
Not as long as her opponent was on court. She was on court for only 55 minutes, but it was a much, much closer match. Much closer in the third game.
Well, there's not a lot the doctor can do. They're not allowed to treat on court. They can only give an opinion on the extent of the injury. I think you're right, Jill. I think we're seeing the end of it here.
Yeah. I mean, in all fairness, to beat the world number one, although she's only the number two seed here, Yihan, to beat her, you really do have to be on top form. You have to be 100%, don't you?
I think that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, calling it a day. And the hometown player, Wang Yihan, from this city of Shanghai, takes her first ever China Open title at a seventh attempt. Seventh appearance here. And this year, she's the champion. Her sixth title of the year. Her third premier title of the year, because of course she won the Korean Open and the Indonesian Open as well. Well, that's very sad indeed that we're not seeing this match through to its natural conclusion. With the top two players on the Super Series list. It's a match that I had been looking forward to. But after just 30 points at 18-12, Wang Sin retiring from the final. And I'm sure it will take the presentation party a little while to get ready for this presentation for the women's singles. Let's just reflect a little bit on the singles in general, the women's singles. And I've already mentioned the fact that Wang Shuxian lost out to the world junior champion as we enjoy some of the highlights from that. Well, in fact, that's the point where Wang Sin said she'd had enough. But also Sina Nawal, number four seed, she went in the very first round. It was an event with numerous upsets. And there you can see that just partway through that opening game, 18-12 was the scoreline. And you can see the three finals we've yet to come. But Ian, it has been a discipline of upsets.
Yes, but to be fair, Jill, this year we've seen a lot of upsets in the ladies' singles. There's a little bit of a changing of the guard. There's some very good younger players coming through at the moment. There's a couple of very good young Thailand players. We've seen the younger Taipei girl come through. And it's a very interesting discipline at the moment. There have been a lot of surprises throughout the whole year. And that's certainly been the case this week.
Yes, in fact, the youngster from Taipei, Tai Si Ying has had two victories over Wang Xin this year, so that's an indication of just how much potential she's got.
Yeah, and of course in the World Championships we saw plenty of upsets there as well in the ladies' singles. It's a very, very interesting event at the moment.
Yeah, because it's been dominated by China for so long, but I think this is really exciting times for women's singles.
Well, certainly Infanon's coming through from Thailand and playing some great badminton. Pawntip's also had some good results from Thailand. Taipei girls really upset the Chinese on several occasions. She's had wins against number one seed, number two seed. Not quite been able to follow it through to actually win an event yet, but it's coming.
About to get underway. Last time a non-Chinese player won the women's singles here, I think we have to go back to Wang Mengqiu from Malaysia. Was that in 2007 or 2008? China have dominated on home soil for a long, long time. Yihan, her sixth title of the year. Wang Xin's record of winning every final that she's reached this year came to an abrupt end here in Shanghai.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see whether she recovers in time for the Super Series finals now.
No, indeed.
She's only got a couple of weeks.
Or some of the players going on to the Macau Open next week, the Grand Prix event.
Yes. It's a very charged time of the year for the calendar.
The winner's check for Wang Yihan. Just checks it. It is indeed $26,250. For the photographers. 11 titles this year between those two players. But Wang Yihan